Hey you. Hey, person that threw the dirty baby diaper in the parking lot outside of my mattress store. Hey, pick it up, all right? Don't put dirty baby diapers in the parking lot. Don't litter like that. And if you're gonna litter, I mean, does it have to be a dirty baby diaper? I don't want you to come leave it in my store bathroom either. You know what you need to do? You need to do just like when you're gonna go in the wilderness and camp, pack it in and pack it out. Don't be a jerk. Don't leave the stinky baby diaper in the store bathroom. Don't leave it in the parking lot. You know, I'll be honest. I think the people that leave dirty baby diapers in the parking lot should go to jail. Maybe not jail, but you know that $1,000 littering sign that you see, but nobody ever gets a ticket? I think you should get the $1,000 fine. That's what I think. So I don't want to see your dirty baby diaper in my parking lot ever again. So I had a customer come in earlier today and she was like, let me write you a check and you hold it and then I'll bring you cash when I come back and you can give me my check back. And I was kind of like, how about you just bring me the money when you come back? I believe you. I believe you're coming back. So it got me thinking about checks. I don't have checks. Amanda, we do have checks, but I don't carry them with me. And I don't pay anything with a check. I have a couple of things I pay with money orders, and if I take them a check, they're like, we really would rather you bring us a money order. People don't really want checks. I, as a business owner, I don't want to take a check. I don't know if you've got money in your bank account. I don't know if you do, then I cash your check later. Are you still going to? I don't know. Yeah, checks. I think that they're kind of a thing of the past. I got a new debit card in the mail today, and it doesn't even have the number embossed. It's all about the chip now. So I think we're going to all chips all the time. I don't think checks have a big place in our future. On another note, I got an old pickup truck. I got a 1972 Ford F-100. It is super cool. I'd be showing it to you right now, but I have it in the shop getting an exhaust leak fixed. So I'm super excited about my truck. I have some footage of me taking it to the mechanic and stuff like that. I'm gonna do a separate video of that. I've been building up footage for that. So, if you watch Amanda's Instagram story, then you've seen my terrible office at work. It's actually a really nice little cozy spot for me. I spend a lot of time back here. I really like it, but there's some trouble. You see this? You see right there? That's where there's a missing panel in the ceiling. So if I don't clog that up, if I don't cover that up with stuff, wind flows through and pulls the front door open of the store. So, there's a cardboard box up there. There's an old mattress sign. You guys might remember that mattress sign from the Arrow video. So yeah, this is my office. It looks like a hoarder corner, but it's not, okay? Look, up there I got some office supplies and stuff. Price books, I know they're dangling. Then right here, I've got personal stuff. Right here, I've got incense and a teapot. There's tools and things that go to putting furniture together. There's a checkbook and some other stuff. There's food. Okay, and then over here, I know I do have an extra sparkles machine that needs to go. Tying twine, mattress protectors from there down. That cardboard box and that cardboard box, they could go. Madison asked me to save her some cardboard and I did. Now I'm thinking I'm just gonna throw it away. And then up there, obviously, is where I've patched the ceiling. Oh yeah, way down there, there's some paper. It looks like a hoarder corner, but it's not.